Good morning and praise the Lord. I'm happy to be with you once again in our today's Daily Bite, which is coming from the book of Psalms 122, verses 1 and 2. May we read it together. The Bible says, I was glad when they said to me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet have been standing within your gates, O Jerusalem. Holy Spirit, we love you. And we surrender to you. I pray that you speak to our lives, and my God, to the glory of your name. Thank you because of my viewer. I speak a blessing upon him or her in Jesus' name. Amen. My dear viewer, this morning I have a simple question for you and for me. Do you long for the house of the Lord? Do you normally feel that strong feeling, that strong desire to go to the house of the Lord? Do you miss the house of the Lord? Is there a time that you sit, or maybe you walk or you work, and you just feel you are longing for that time when you are going to be in the house of the Lord, in the presence of the Lord, in the midst of men and women who are believers like you? Do you reach a point in your life where you have that strong longing, such that you feel you may be having everything else, but you feel whatever else you have does not mean much, but you just desire to be in the presence of God, to be in the presence of God's people? Because the house of God, where we go for worship, where we go and we hear the word of God, that is the best place. The Bible says it is the best place for one to be, more than any other place in the whole world, which is a reflection of the place where we shall live with God forever. So, as we look at the churches at this particular time during the COVID-19, when the churches have been closed all over the world for weeks and even for months, many people have not been allowed to gather. Even you and I have not been gathering. But do you have that longing? Are you asking yourself, when will I have a chance to gather with God's people and raise our voices to God in worship? Do you have that longing? That's my message for you this morning. I want to refer you to the words of God in the book of Psalms 26 and verse 8, which says, Psalms 26 verse 8 says, Lord, I love the habitation of your house and the place where your glory dwells. The psalmist says, I love the habitation. I love the habitation of your house. I love your house. These are the confessions of the psalmist. I love the habitation of your house and the place where your glory dwells. That is the church. Do you long for it? Again, in the book of Psalms 27 verse 4, this is what the Bible says. What thing have I asked of the Lord? That will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord. That I may dwell. Not that I may be a visitor. Not that I may be a passerby. But that I may be a dweller. I may be somebody who spends time in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze upon the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. Not to inquire from the government. Not to inquire from your parents. Not to inquire from the other authorities. The psalmist says, whatever concerns him in life, whatever concerns her in life, he wants to inquire in the house of the Lord. Do you love it? Do you long for it? I also want to quote another psalmist, Psalms 84 verse 1 and 2. It says this, how lovely is your dwelling place, O Lord. O Lord of hosts, my soul longs. My soul longs. Yes, faints for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh sing for joy to the living God. These are the expressions, words coming from the bottom of the heart of the psalmist, expressing her desire, her longing, her that strong feeling for the house of the Lord. And feeling, anything else may not matter, but the house of the Lord matters to his life. Does the house of the Lord matter to you? Does the house of God matter to your family? These are strong questions to ask. This reminds me of Jesus at the age of 12.
getting lost in the house of the Lord. Parents looking for him, and he was just lost in the house of the Lord. And he was asking the parents, why are you looking for me? Don't you know I am in my father's house? He had a longing. Do you have that longing? Do you have that? Do you miss it? Do you feel at this time we have overstayed? Do you have a prayer that God, can't the church be open that we may go and worship? Recently, I heard the words of a man of God from America saying that, yes, people are talking about opening restaurants, opening this and that, opening the economy. But we have people who are yearning for the opening of the church so that we can go and worship. These words are in line with those words that were spoken by this man of God. Do you have people who are yearning to go and worship, who are yearning to go and sing in the choir, who are yearning to go and do prayers together with others? That is the big question. So what am I saying? David says, I was glad when they told me, let us go to the house of the Lord. Are you glad? Or are you sad? Or do you feel bad? Which of the three? David said, I was glad. But with you, do you feel sad? Do you feel bad when you are told, let us go to the house of the Lord? David said, I was glad. From today, I declare that you are glad. Whenever you hear, let us go into the house of the Lord. The church is a family. When you look at those words, in the book of Psalms 122, it says, let us go as a family. Let us go into the house of the Lord. Why? In the house of the Lord, the entire family we are gathering. The entire family we are worshiping. With the entire family we are appearing before the King of Kings. Everything else we are doing in this life, the businesses we are doing, the employment we are pursuing, the positions and titles we have, don't forget they will come to an end. But the house of the Lord is where we are prepared for eternity. And that's why David says, I was glad. Even when, let us go into that house. So what am I saying? The house of the Lord is not in outside your door. You can read in this word, Psalms 122, let us go. In other words, it is a journey. It is a place you go. It is a place you walk. It is a place you drive. Let us go. So, the big question is, are you willing to be making that journey? Do you have that desire? Are you glad when you are told, let us go. Let us cover this distance. Let us go to the house where our Father is, where his presence is. From today, may that desire, may that hunger, may that appetite be in you for the house of the Lord. All these other houses that we are living in will come to an end. They will pass away. But the presence of God will be for us forever as Christians. So as I come to the conclusion, I want to say that David had two reasons why he was hungering. He was glad for that he was going to the house of the Lord. Number one, to hear and heed God's word. You can get that from the scriptures that we have just read. Psalms 122. That is number one reason where he was going to seek counsel. Where he was going to be advised, given direction, encouragement, and everything, guidance of his life. It is that word, you can only get it in the house of the Lord. So number one reason was to hear and heed God's word. And he knew every opportunity that he went into God's house, it was an opportunity to hear the word from the book, from the Bible, and also to share, to get the sharing of the word. So the life-giving words. What you read in books will come to an end. What you read in papers will come to an end. But what you hear from the Bible will keep you alive for eternity. And number two reason why he was going into the house of the Lord was so that he could meet God. Because the presence of God dwells where God's people are. Jesus said, where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am in the midst. So he was longing for that time when he would gather with others. And as he gathers with others, then he is going to be nourished. I want to finish by saying this. The book of Psalms 84 verse 10 says, there is no place on earth better. I would rather be a doorkeeper in God's house rather than be in all other those other places. That is Psalms 84 verse 10. So as I finish, what a glorious day shall that be when people shall go and say, come ye and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the Lord of Jacob, and he will teach us of his ways, and we will walk in his paths. That is in the book of Isaiah, chapter 2, verses 1 to 3. Do you miss the house of God? Do you long for the house of the Lord? May the Lord put that desire, that hunger, that thirst, which cannot be quenched by anything else other than just being in the house of the Lord. May we pray together. Jesus, we love you. And we thank you because of the house of the Lord. And how much we need to desire to be in your presence in the house of the Lord. Together with others, as we worship, as we raise our voices in adoration, I pray for my viewer that this morning you're going to put that desire, that hunger, that appetite that cannot be satisfied by anything else other than being in your house. Lord, we give you the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. May the Lord bless you. 10 o'clock tomorrow morning, let us meet together. Let us be together on Facebook and YouTube from 10 o'clock for our Sunday service in Jesus' name. May the Lord bless you. Amen.